Good morning, kids of St. Peter's. It's Adam Lefevre Hughes. I'm your director of music, and we have a lesson today for you all about Moses and the burning bush. So we have a craft for you to work on, and a story to listen to, and some other interesting things to think about. So hope you enjoy this, and I hope you have a really great time.
So for today's craft, you're going to need a few things. You can use some paper bags to draw on, some markers or colored pencils or crayons, and either you can use candles, or you could use a flashlight to be the light of the burning bush. So what we're going to do is we're going to draw bushes onto our bags here, put a candle in them and light it up, and we'll get a burning bush that does not burn up. So let's watch Sam and Nick in action.
I need some gray. All right, this may not be gray, but it's pretty good. Big mountain.
So Nick's working on his bush here.
Red line. Well, red sticks.
Yeah, and his bush has some kind of sticks that come out like that. They look really good.
Three on each side.
Sam over here is also working on his. Oh, very nice. Oh, and he has a larger tree.
Mountain.
Oh,
it's
mountain,
supposed
I'm
to
sorry.
Be a mountain in distance.
I understand. A
Dad,
nice mountain there.
I'm going to make yellow leaves.
Okay. So here we're drawing our bushes on bags, on these white bags we happen to have at home. And they're looking great.
Snow cap.
Here I drew one ahead of time. And I decided to put a nice sun on my bag.
There we go. That looks pretty snow capped.
Okay, we're working hard on our bushes here. We're almost done.
Yeah.
Filling in some sky over here.
I might need the white for my clouds.
The white won't show up very well. So like if you did some yellow for the outline.
Looking really good, Nick. All right, we finished drawing the bushes on our bags here. We have the
Look
one.
Look at mine.
Yeah, here's the one that I made, and this is the one Sam made, and here's the one Nick made.
With the blue sky. With
three
blue
different
sun.
Kinds of bushes.
Yep.
And I have them here with me. Here's Sam.
Mm-hmm.
And here is
Nick.
And what we're going to do is we're going to each put a candle inside our bag. So
I don't want to put mine in mine.
Oh, it won't be lit. You can just put it right in. So we'll put it in.
Oh, I'll put mine in mine.
Okay. Put our candles in. Yep. Right in the middle.
Yep, that's what I'm trying to do.
I put mine close to the middle.
Great.
Enough.
Here, I'll help a little.
No thanks.
Okay.
There we go.
All right. So now we've done that, what we're going to do is we're going to take, well, we call these, lovingly call these in our house, a fire stick. But you might call it something else. Anyway, we're going to use this to light our candles. All right? So we're going to do that. Of course, do this only if you have an adult around so that we stay safe. So we're going to go ahead and light our candles, and then we'll talk a little bit more. Ooh. Oh, step back. Okay, so we have now lit the candles in our bags, and as you can see, the bushes look like they're on fire.
Yeah.
But they're not burning up. So just like the bush that was on fire and didn't burn up for Moses, we have here bushes that are kind of on fire, but they're not burning up.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Mine didn't work very well. Because it's so tiny.
Oh, you know what? It just looks a little different. That's okay.
Hey, there's still like fire floating up there.
So, there's our craft for this week.
Kind of burning your mountain.
Yeah.
Yep. So there's our craft for this week. Hope you have fun with it. All right, now that we've finished our craft for this week, I thought we could read a story. So, this is called The Burning Bush.
Mm-hmm.
Moses was watching his sheep in the hot, dry desert. Suddenly, he saw a very strange sight. Flames of fire came from a bush, but the bush did not burn up. Moses squinted his eyes. He looked around the bush one way, and he looked around the bush the other way. "Moses! Moses!" said a loud voice. Moses was scared. "Here I am," he said. "Take off your shoes," the voice thundered. "The place where you are standing is holy ground." Moses kicked off his sandals, keeping his eyes on the flaming bush. "I am the God of your fathers," the voice said. Moses hid his face. He was afraid to look at God. "I have heard my people crying in Egypt," God said. "Many people are hurting, and I have come to save them." "Wow," thought Moses, "how will God do this?" "Go," said God. "I am sending you to Pharaoh to ask him to let my people go." "Me?" said Moses. "Who am I to go to Pharaoh? Who am I to lead your people?" He threw himself down onto the ground before God, but he kept one eye on the burning bush. "I will be with you," God said. Moses trusted God. He was willing to do everything God said. God gave Moses the words and power he needed to talk to Pharaoh and lead the people out of Egypt. So I forgot to show the pictures here. This is the beginning of the story of the burning bush. You see, he's tending his sheep, right? And then here's where he's talking to God and hiding his face. But look, he's keeping one eye on that burning bush. Probably a good idea. What do you guys think?
Yeah.
If you were near a burning bush, you'd want to keep an eye on it, huh?
Yeah.
So I want to ask you guys about the story a little bit. God asked Moses to do a really hard thing. You see, there were people who were kind of captured. They were forced to work for someone. And God said to Moses, "You need to go to this person who's keeping these people and say, 'Let them go.'" Does that sound like it's an easy thing to do?
Mm-mm-mm.
No. Can you think of a time when you had to do something that was hard, or someone asked you to do something that was tough?
You asking me to clean my room?
Oh, yeah. That can be hard. It can look like a lot to do, can't it?
Yeah.
Okay. So what did you do when I asked you?
I went and did it little by little.
Yeah, little by little, kind of broke it down into smaller bits. Yeah. How about you, Nick? What was there a time that...
I took, like, some breaks sometimes.
Oh, sure. Sure.
Sometimes in my life.
Yeah.
Well, days.
How about, let's see, were there times then that maybe I came and helped you a little bit clean
yeah.
your room?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and even I kind of went with you. Yeah. So in this story, God says to Moses, "You need to go do this really hard thing." And Moses, what does Moses say?
I don't know.
He says, "Really?
Really me?" Right? But then God tells Moses something that helps him feel better. Do you remember what that was?
I will be with you.
I will be with you. Yeah, God tells Moses that God will go with Moses the whole way. What do you think about you guys? Do you think God will go with you anywhere you go?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yes.
He's all around us.
God is all around us, which means that...
Even right here.
Even right here.
All the way around, all over the world.
And even... So what that means, I guess, maybe, is that if God is always all around us, even if we have hard things to do, what do you think that means? That we're never really left alone to do them,
yeah.
right? God goes with us.
Mm-hmm.
And God supports us.
What does that mean?
Oh, God lets us know that God loves us.
Which we can't hear.
Well, maybe we can't hear like Moses did with the burning bush, but what are other ways that we know that we're loved?
Hugs and kisses.
Hugs and kisses from who?
Me and the family.
From your family, right. Yeah. And right, and also, oh, just a moment, and also your friends, right, being nice and being nice to other people. We show each other we love each other. Okay, so, that's, Dad. Oh yes, what?
Was it the burning bush in actual life?
That's an excellent question. I have never seen a bush do that before. What about you?
No, I haven't
either. But you know what? I believe that God can do some amazing things. How about you?
What if I write a story of him healing lots of people?
Sure.
How? Sure.
Well, that might be a story for another time. But for now, let's end by saying, you know what? Even if it feels like you're all alone doing something hard, what do we now know?
What? That God is always with us.
That God is always with us, even if we have to do something that's hard. Does that sound right?
Mm-hmm. All right. Like cleaning a room.
Like cleaning a room. or anything else like that. Okay.
Yep.
Well, let's say bye, and we'll see you next week.
Bye.
Hope everyone has a great week.
Bye.
Hey, kids, it's me again. And I thought we could sing a little bit still this week. It's still Easter. It's only the third week of Easter. That's 3 out of 7 whole weeks of Easter. So I thought we should try another Alleluia. Remember last week's Alleluia? It went, Halle, Halle, Hallelujah. You remember that one? It's a lot of fun. So I thought we could sing that one and then learn a new one. So let's do that. Halle, Halle, Halle. Some of you thought I forgot about the clap, but I didn't. So, oh great! Oh, I love that one. It's so much fun. So here's another Alleluia. It starts up here, and it goes, Hallelujah, 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 Hallelujah. It's a lot of fun too. So let's break it down. The first part is Hallelujah. Sing that. Hallelujah. And the next part is Hallelujah. Sing that. Hallelujah. And the third part's a little longer. Hallelujah. Sing it.
Hallelujah.
And the next part's a repeat of the first part. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Sing that.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
And the last part ends differently. Hallelujah. Sing it.
Hallelujah.
So all together now, let's try it. We'll do it about 2 or 3 times. Here we go.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Hope you have a great week, and we'll see you later. Bye.